Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the difference between interface and abstract class. Both interface and abstract class are used to hide the internal implementation of the feature and show only main functionality to the user. That is, both interface and abstract class are used for abstraction. Now let us see the differences between both by taking an example. Let us create a class. I'll name my class as interface example, and we are going to create an interface. I'll name my interface as I, and I am going to create a integer variable here, and we'll assign the value as 10 here. So all the data members by default in interface are public, static, final. It is final. The data members are public, as it has to be accessed across all the classes. It is static, as we can't instantiate the interface. So we can't create the object for an interface, right? So that's why the only way we can actually access the data members is by using the interface name. That's why it is static. And final, as if there could be a conflict, if there is more than one class implementing this interface and trying to change the value of this data member. That's why the data members in interface are always final. And if you observe, we are not mentioning this either public, static, or final, but it's internally done. So it's internally considered as public, static, final. All the data members in interface are public, static, final by default. And let's have some method here in interface. I'll name this as display. All the methods within the interface are abstract and by default public. Again, like it is public, as it has to be accessed across all the classes, and it is abstract, as we are not having the body for this method. We are only declaring the method here and we are not providing the implementation for this. So such type of methods are called abstract methods. So in interface, we can only have abstract methods, only abstract methods. That's why we can call that like interface as 100% abstraction, or it's called as 100% abstraction class. Now let's implement this interface I. So as we are going to implement this, we need to override the methods within the interface. So let's do that now. Let's override this display method. So I'm just going to display some message as this is display method of interface I. And now let's create a main method, and I'm going to create a reference type variable for the interface. We have the interface I, right? I'm going to create a reference type and instantiate with the interface example class. I'm going to use this reference type to call the display method. And then we have a data member I, right? So if we try to actually assign some value to it, see, we get an error saying that cannot assign a value to final variable. If you observe, we didn't declare it as final, but we are getting this error. So this proves that this variable is final, right? So we can't modify the value of a data member which is actually defined in interface. So the only way we can actually access it is, we can't modify it, and we can actually access it using the interface name itself, i.i. Now let us actually execute this example. And we can see here, so this display method got actually invoked, and we can see the message, and we can actually see the value of I got displayed here, right? So this is the interface example. Now let us understand the abstract class. I'll name this class as abstract class example, and I'm going to create a class here which is abstract. I'm going to name this class also as abstract class, where we are going to have a data member, maybe int, sum int I equal to 0, but I am going to have it as some other access modifier, some protected, right? And I am going to have another data member which is static final. I'll have this value as some f, and we can have both abstract methods as well as concrete method, that is non-abstract methods within an abstract class. So I'm going to create an abstract method here, and this has to be preceded with an abstract keyword. This is my abstract method within an abstract class, and I'm going to create another method. If you observe, I'm going to create another method display where I can provide the body to this method. So I'll say this as non-abstract method. So within an abstract class, we can have both abstract method and non-abstract method. Abstract method is where we don't have the implementation logic for it. We only declare the method here. The class which is extending the abstract class will actually give the or provide the implementation for this method. And we can also have non-abstract methods or concrete methods where we actually provide the body for these methods. All right, now let's extend this class, this abstract class, and then we need to implement the methods, abstract methods, right? Now we'll say that this is show method of abstract class, right? Now let us create a main method where we are going to create reference type for abstract class. I'll just say A and instantiate with abstract class example, this class, right? Now let's access A.I. So what's A.I here? 0, right? First, let's actually call the methods A.display and A.show. Now we can actually modify this value I, which is protected. If you observe, this is not final. So I can actually modify this value to some 10 and can actually print this value here. But if I try to actually, f is a static final, right? So it is static. So we can actually call it or invoke it using the class name, abstract class dot f equal to 200. So this can't be done as f is final here, right? So we can't actually modify the value of f here as it is final. So let's display the value of f. Now let us execute this program. So if you observe, first we'll have this is show of A.display. Actually, this has to display the non-abstract method. Yeah, it displayed here. And then we actually invoked A.show. So this displayed the show of abstract class. And we are actually displaying A.i and A.abstractClass.f. We got the values here. So this is about the abstract class, right? Now let us understand the differences. So the first difference we can see here is an interface is preceded with a keyword interface, whereas abstract class is preceded with a keyword called abstract, and all the variables, data members within the interface are public by default, whereas in abstract class it is not a restriction. We can have the access modifier as private, protected, and any other access modifier as well. And all the data members by default are static, but in abstract class, we can either have static variables or non-static variables. And next difference is, like, all the data members are final, whereas in abstract class, we can see here, we can have final variables, we can even have the non-final variables as well. And next, all the methods within the interface are abstract by default. The only exception to this is from Java 8, we can actually have the default methods where we'll provide the body for the methods. And in abstract class, we can either have we can have both abstract methods as well as non-abstract methods. This is another difference. And coming to here, like implementation. Any class can implement the interface using the implements keyword. Any class can actually extend the abstract class using the keyword extends. And another example is like any class can implement more than one interface. Say for example, I have some other interface here. So we can actually implement more than one interface. A class can implement more than one interface, but a class can't extend more than one class as multiple inheritance is not supported in Java. So these are the main differences between interface and abstract class. Now, the question is when to use what, right? So when to use interface, when to use abstract class? Well, so if you don't know the implementation logic, but if you know the requirement specification, then we choose interfaces. Whereas if you only know the implementation part for only some of the methods, and for some of the methods, you're not sure of the implementation, then we'll actually prefer creating the abstract class. So that is how we should actually choose between interface and abstract class. So in this video, we started with knowing what interface is, what abstract class is, and we saw an example on both interface and abstract class. And finally, we discussed differences between interface and abstract class. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.